mic is a lyrical throwdown. It's a lyrical throwdown. Next generation of the underground sound. Kid on the mic is a lyrical throwdown. Next generation of the underground sound. Underground sound. Underground sound. Underground sound. Underground sound. Underground sound.
Thank you. Focused on your hips and thighs. This is a test of the broadcast system. Alrighty, let's back out there. I got my mic turned on now. I think I'm at a point to where I want to start gluing this stuff down. And then we'll do in the smaller details and then start carving after the glue's dry. So the other side is not, how to say, screwed together. Like this is all screwed together, packed together using screws, essentially. So I need to take out all these loose pieces that I'm not currently using. I think I'm gonna stack them all in this corner over here and hope that the rabbits don't decide to go chewing on it. So I got some construction pieces, which is meant for foam boards, which this is. So I'm hoping that's not going to give me too many issues. Currently right now, I'm just trying to clear off this table. Is what I'm going to do is do the side fountains to start with. And then, but I want to place them on this table over here, out of the way, while I glue them on. And I'm also going to do a quick little vacuum too. Just to get this all cleared off. So the garbage picked up and whatnot, so I'm not tripping over stuff. The other thing I gotta do is some of these pieces still have plastic coatings on it. So I got the fun job of peeling that back. I'm more back here. The floor is just an absolute mess at the moment. But I got a lot of carving done today. A lot of the pieces cut out. I did a lot last night too. I know I said I was going to bed last night, but I fully tried and I didn't, so I stayed up for a couple hours, cut a bunch of pieces. Then this morning I cut some more. I did the one pontoon this morning, or last night, did the other pontoon this morning, and then did some of the pontoon this morning, this afternoonish, and then I got the stream going. And if you're in the stream, I guess you would have saw what I got done thus far. But, all right. So I'm just trying to get these bigger pieces that the vacuum cleaner doesn't really like all that much. But they're too small for me to use. Yeah, go ahead and down that vacuum. It's in the bedroom. Using it to do the cages this morning. Smells like one of my rabbits got diarrhea. Which isn't good. One of you two in there is stinky. Just did the litter boxes too last night. Alright. That's done. Now we gotta move all this crap over. This is falling quickly. So I'll just come right off. So these ones are just pinned in from the side. Then this one here, last one here, is pinned in from underneath. I should be able to just pull up on it. Oh no, it took the screws with it. Oh, someone's safe. Yeah. Them pinned with screws, so you've got to pull all these screws out. This is the first one I'm gonna lay. Because I made sure it had a perfect edge and everything, and we gotta make sure that this one is perfectly squared up with this line. And same thing with the other one on the other side. It needs to be perfectly squared up with this line. And the boat should come out square. Even if I get the nose slightly off, because these two side pontoon bits are going to be perfectly square, it'll draw the boat out straight. And that's what the whole goal of why I've been fussing over this for so long with is. So, we're still not out of the woods yet. We still got a bit of work to do on this. So, I'm just hoping I didn't screw up because I left the container plugged into the canister all night. And I don't know. How that turned out. I guess I could do like a little test to go. Like I kept it all. Shoot a little bit in the garbage to make sure that it still isn't. Yeah, we're good. All right. The little bit that was in the nozzle still was extremely thick, but once that cleared out, yeah, it's definitely not a good idea to leave this in the can overnight. Definitely gonna want to disconnect that next time. Okay, so my one concern that I had is now past, but I gotta lose the sweatshirt. I am baking hot.
Of the underground.
Alright, so my uncle is just popping by.
Whoa. I'm dropping stuff.
Probably not gonna be having a late night tonight. I want to make sure that there's nothing on there that's gonna cause this stuff not to stick. Yeah, we gotta peel this plastic crap off of it too. So cooperative. I know that if I try to glue it to this, it's just not gonna stick. It's gonna peel. Dang. Thank you. Oh my god. Like, fuck. Constantly, it's all coming off, just little tiny pieces. It's actually making me mad. We got most of the top edge done. Fuck it. One little piece I can see that's... are digging on, that's why it's like all weird. No, screw it. It's gonna go on like that. It'll stick. I got the majority of it done. The rabbits got a good job perforating it already. It's clogged.
Thank you.
so cooperative. Oh, stop being such a fucking bastard. Damn, I got the screws again. It's not sticking. I'm gonna have to put this whole thing on the floor before I do this. I wanted to do that at the beginning because I knew this wasn't gonna stick properly. Got no pressure to be able to put pressure on it. It just keeps flimsing down and popping apart. Turning into a jigsaw puzzle and I have to put it back together, gosh darn it. I hope that this doesn't break when I go to pull it down. Take this one board off now. Alright, that worked. Ish. I don't think there was too much damage, but we got it on the floor. Even stick this thing on now. Never stop the fucking rave, never stop the fucking move.
down to the grave. Never stop the fucking beat. Never stop the fucking rave. Never stop the fucking move. Never stop until the grave. Never stop the fucking beat. 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 Never stop the fucking beat.
Give this some fresh air. Oh, it's all good. A nuclear fallout siren? I'm not too sure. Oh, maybe that was a vacuum cleaner? Or something in the song? I'm not too sure. I just gotta let that one piece rest for about a minute or two. And then I should be good to start sticking other pieces to it. Some might say I could start on the other ones, but I don't want to get pieces confused. And I don't got enough space to... Actually, I could put those other pieces up onto the... There. No, we're just one pontoon at a time. That way we get everything done right. But it's almost done. It stuck up nice. So, little bit more work to do. It's just getting all the pieces glued down now. Then I can finish getting the little pieces kind of like done in between, and then I should be able to start shaving and sanding. And yeah, so I'm gonna carve out the bottom shape, and then I'm gonna flip it over and start building it up with more foam. So I have to make it in sections. So at 16 feet long, I have to go out this one window to get it out of here, and it's 20 inches of window. So I'm making it 18 inches, so I have 2 inches of play. Damn, indigestion. But, yeah. So it's one of those do-do-do-do-do, twiddle the thumbs until this glue kind of sets up a bit better than what it is. This is gonna take a little bit for it to set up. I'm just excited for the whole sanding bit, because once I can get the sanding and getting it thickened up. So I could have done this a lot easier, but it would have cost me way more money in the foam department. So to cut the cost by like 2/3, I'm doing it in small little pieces and building it up. So eventually what we're gonna be doing is doing fiberglass and a body fill and a bit more fiberglass and a resin to strengthen it and to make it perfect. And then probably a gel coat as well, just to make it look pretty. And it'll also just finish making that just perfect gloss finish. So the goal is then we'll use that as a plug to make a mold. And then we'll use that mold to actually make the fiberglass boat. Now, I think the first one's gonna be fiberglass, and then once I get, maybe down the road, we get a bit more funding and stuff like that, then we can look at different carbon fiber and different composites and stuff like that. But those are gonna cost more, and I just want a working prototype to say, hey, here's a really cool boat, come put your orders in, I'll make you one up. Let's go. So this boat is designed to be on skinny water. So that means like, I don't want it drafting any more than 6 to 8 inches. Like I want you to be able to go through a foot of water and not have any issues. That's the goal for it. For top deck designs, I have like 3 or 4, 5 or 6 in my head of how I could do the top deck. But the first top deck is gonna be like an El Camino style type thing. So I want it like a pickup truck style. I'm just thinking, yeah, I just have a few thoughts. I'm getting ahead of myself here, so. But. I think the more interesting bit is once we actually get at least like halfway through this project and we can go over these streams and take clips out and make like a proper video out of it. Like how you see everybody else on YouTube when they make a video of, I made a jet boat, I made this. They're showing you little clips and stuff. They're not showing you the full build. but I decided to stream the full build. And then, like, once we get to certain points, I'll go over those streams, take clips from those streams, and patch them together, make a proper video. I'm also doing this with webcams. I don't even have a proper camera. My one camera is broken and doesn't work, and I'm kind of upset that it doesn't want to work for me. My one friend's like, oh, it's just the battery's dead, and I'm just like, it's not. Like, I bought a charger and everything, tried to charge it, didn't want to charge. I do believe the battery's dead, but not in the sense that he's saying it's dead. I think it's dead as in defunct, like, not even gonna take a charge, not gonna give a charge, not gonna do nothing. It's just a piece of plastic that's got a bit of metal inside of it at this point. As for the actual camera itself, I don't know. I haven't been able to put power to it to see if it turns on. But yeah, it's kind of frustrating. It's also an $800 camera that I got for $80. So, I don't know. Ooh, this shifted on me. It's not good. I might have to make a run to the Home Depot to get more glue. To be perfectly honest. Just that good adhesion. Top edges. As I get this back end lined up, I go to pull this one in. Everything should line up nicely. I wish I had clamps, but clamps are expensive.
Okay.
She's good. This piece is ready to go. This other piece is not. Get all this plastic crap off of it. I'm gonna be looking at it as well. So I think they close at 8:30. I know. You can hear that, eh? Just like all these little tiny pieces. I would do it over there, but then I would have a big pile of plastic in the way. So that's why I'm doing it a little bit off camera here. Plastic's killing me, though. I figured as long as I get the plastic taken away from like the outer edges, then I should be alright. Because that's like where the foam is going to be sticking for the most part and where I'm going to be sanding and cutting. And yeah. Alright. That one's good enough. Alright. I do believe I have that design to go to the red line. Yep. There. Alright, push this one. Actually, we're gonna do this back piece first. And then do this front piece. Oh, you stay out of it. So Rudy's jumped in glue on me before, and this glue here will hurt him to get it off of him. So we gotta make sure he doesn't jump in the glue. Should just go lock him in the room. It. He halfway knows. I think he learned from the last time he got glue on him. He's like, what is that noise? Probably what drove him out of here. Well, this little rabbit chills long enough for me to get this all glued together. So do you or not? Just don't want him getting in his glue. Oh, the color's not matching. Yeah, I'm painting over it. It's not gonna be seen. Video capture device. Properties. Deactivate. Activate. Alright. Sorry about that. Little technical difficulties. I just decided to see how hard I could kick that wire. More plastic, and then we're going for the next row. Yeah, the mixed matching color is kind of annoying me too, but the cost of foam is a lot. Luckily for us, all the white foam's already done. It's just all this black crap that we gotta peel back. It's not being cooperative! Oh. nearly there. It is. Like, you don't even know, like, how annoying. I already did one model. Like, literally, that's this, the way this stuff is peeling, it's why I bought the white foam, because the white foam peels back so easy. Comes off in big chunks, where this stuff, it's like little itty-bitty pieces. But this foam here is also like 2 years old. I'm recycling it from other projects. Another one. I know, it's like, would be nice. It keeps doing that. But my rabbits were messing with this foam as well too. So they put a lot of holes in it on me. So there's a lot of fracture points in the plastic, I guess. Satisfying. Keep jinxing it. Good enough. My chat in Streamlabs doesn't keep up to date the same as my chat in YouTube. Kind of annoying. Oh, fish is stick. Yeah, I know. This is actually coming out pretty solid. No. Just like duct tape, when all else fails, more glue. It's not sticking, obviously.
Just can't let you go. Lord knows that I've tried to. You said I was the only one. No one likes being lied to. You made this mess and left me with the pieces. Now I wanna burn all the bridges between. We'll be right back.
Oof.
Breaking my back just to know your name. But heaven ain't close in a place like this. Anything goes, but don't blame you, my miss. Cause heaven ain't close in a place like this. I said heaven ain't close in a place like this. Don't bring it back down, bring it back down tonight. I never thought I'd let it run . Somebody told me you had a boyfriend who looked like a girlfriend, but I hadn't heard you. Harry, I lost you. It's not confidential. I got potential.
I gotta clean that tip off.
Take my hand, sailing the same course. Why?
Well, that seems to be holding together all right. To this door before they close.
What are we waiting for? What are we waiting for? What are we waiting for?
I thought putting all these pieces together was going to be the easy part. I thought carving it was going to be the hard part. But it turns out gluing all these pieces together is the hard part, and the carving is going to be the easy part. Just like...
Yeah, I might go lock Rudy in the room. To the store right quick. Well, it's not gonna be right quick. It's like 20 minutes, half hour there, 20 minutes, half hour back. But that's why I wanna go down before it's too late. The Home Depot's a little touch farther away than the grocery stores and stuff like that. But I live in the downtown core, so it's a little bit different.
Thank you. There is a faster way of making plugs, but I don't have a CNC machine. That'd be awesome. If I had unlimited funding, like, to make this would be super simple and quick. But I don't have unlimited funding, so we have to do some workarounds. Yeah, I'm gonna end the stream here. I gotta run to the store. Go get some more glue before we run out. I don't wanna get, like, I can feel the can getting near empty now. And I don't wanna get through any more and be out of glue. Because it will absolutely bother me. I want to have glue left over so I can start cutting more pieces and keep going. Like, if I want to. Yeah. So, bank, then Home Depot, then back home. I'm going to put dinner on the stove when I get home, and then I'll probably start stream back up. But for now, thank you all for joining. Thank you for those likes. Be sure to check on in later on. If you're not signed up for Discord, be sure to sign up for that Discord. Link is not in the description. You'd have to go into the about of the channel. I should probably put the link in the descriptions of these things. But not in this stream. Maybe the next one. For now, guys, take it easy.